Hello everyone, here to show you how to do a oil change on a 22 Bighorn V6 4x4 eTorque. Things you will need is a 10 millimeter socket for these screws here and there. 5 quarts of 0W20 and oil filter according to the manual, catch pan, and also this is a 15/16 flex head ratchet, 3/8 inch drive. You see, I already took the cover off. It's two screws that will. So that was a 10 millimeter. And I warmed up the engine a little bit already, helped the oil run smoother. All right. First, I am going to access the oil pan. It should be right there. Oh, I forgot to mention, you also need a funnel, maybe with a flex pipe, paper towels, and something to put behind your back when you're underneath. You don't need a jack or anything. And 13 millimeter socket with a ratchet. You can see there, there's a screw where you just pop it on. Make sure you're spinning the right way. Okay, so first I'm gonna loosen it up, make sure your catch pan is in the appropriate position. I'm gonna loosen it up first. Sway bar is in the way, but it doesn't matter. I can work around it. Loosen it up. Can be quite tight the first time. Okay. Once it's loose, loosen up by hand. And I warmed the engine up to, for the oil tend to be around 100. Just some idling. I rev the engine a little bit to make it come out smoother. Don't get splashed. Okay, I need both hands for this. See it pouring out now. A little bit of mess, but it's okay. Just wipe it off. A stool or chair also helps, since it's the off-road. Added a little bit of lift to be able to reach the oil filter, which is tucked away there. Again, it's a 15/16 inch socket hex head, or I believe a 24 millimeter. So just put it on here, make sure it's spinning the right way. Yep, spinning the right way, and loosen it up. Okay, This way I don't have to take out any extra parts. Do it some more and loosen up my hand. Okay, now it's loose enough to be taken off by hand. Can't really see that part. Dirty, but okay. Here's what the old and new filter looks like. The new one came with the O-ring. Let's filter again. Make note that number. What I'm gonna do is just untwist it, put it back on. See the old, new O-ring here. Replace that. Now I'm gonna use a pry tool, plastic pry tool, to get it off so I don't damage the threads. Here it is. Okay, now I just hand reinsert the O-ring and pop the filter back in, and now it's going back into the housing here. Okay. So I wiped off the excess oil in the engine bay earlier. Twisting. Okay, once it's tight by hand, just a little quarter turn with the ratchet. Flip the switch. Maybe a little more and then quarter turn since it was kind of loose. Okay, that's pretty good. Check it by hand. Good. Now we come back down here. We'll clean up the mess later. It spilled out a little more than I wanted. Let me just put the screw back in. Important to tighten by hand first so you don't strip the threads. Okay. I'll finish the last few turns with the ratchet. Now on the driver's side of the truck, you can see the light over. cap for the engine oil. I'm just gonna untwist it, put the funnel in. Locks into place. Now to get the engine cover back on, back to the passenger side with this stool. Something like this helps in the beginning. Doesn't have to be too tight. I'm going to get it off. Not destroy the threads. Okay, now we're gonna reset the oil life. Start the truck. I just use these buttons to find on the gauge cluster oil life. Hold OK to reset. Okay, we'll put in accessory mode. Or run without pressing the brake. Hold OK to reset, and there it is. Turn the truck off. Now we gotta check the dipstick, make sure it's the right level. I ran the car just a little bit in park. Take the dipstick here. Wipe it off. Put it back in. Okay, leave it in a few seconds. Twist it around a little bit and let's check. Okay, as you can see, I know it's hard, but I don't know if you can see at all. Well, what it shows that it's in the right spot, it's in between the lines. Great. Now we can put it back in. And that's it.